Opened in 1869, the Atkinson Morley's Hospital is known throughout the world for its treatment of brain injuries and diseases. But the hospital now faces a crisis because of an acute shortage of nurses. Fully staffed, the hospital should have 150 nurses, but it only has 87. As a result, 40% of the hospital's neurosurgical beds are out of use, and 20% of beds in the neurological department lie vacant. The hospital is the South West Thames Regional Centre for Brain Injuries and Diseases, and patients sometimes have to be referred to Southampton. Doctors warn that if the government doesn't act soon, patients are going to die.
Now, the patients particularly at risk from this situation are patients who have suffered hemorrhages inside their head. These normally suffer from accidents, children with head injuries, things like that. And also some patients who've had some forms of stroke. Now, in these patients, urgent diagnosis is required because a small number of them have large blood clots which are rapidly getting bigger. Every minute that goes by, that blood clot is expanding. And they need urgent surgery to remove that blood clot.
Nurses' pay and working hours lie at the root of the problem.
This is partly due to the fact that the work is very demanding. The girls have to work evening shifts, night shifts, weekends. If nurses were able to be paid on a higher rate of pay because they are doing acute demanding work. And also for those nurses who have done a specialised course, for example in neurosurgery and neurology, when they stay on at the end of that course, then they should be recompensed for the extra study and time that they've spent in.
Health Minister Tony Newton declined to be interviewed, but his department said nurses have received a 12.7% pay increase. Terry Dignan at the Atkinson Morley's Hospital for Thames News.